David Pegler here. Look at the European market very briefly for July 26th, 2011. Welcome to FX Bootcamp. This is not an alert service. Not going to make any direct trade recommendations. What I will do is collect some live fundamental technical analysis, hopefully put together some decently profitable trade plans. Please bear in mind that trading heavy leverage is risky, so please not trade your hard-earned money until you have a track record of success using a broker's PlayPlay account. Past performance does not predict future success. All right, guys. So I've got a really simple video here. There's nothing... There's nothing that looks particularly extravagant at all. I want to cover the Aussie and maybe briefly take a look at the euro dollar. Now, I think, you know, if we just look at the Aussie for a minute, this is a daily Aussie chart. All right, we are making a series of higher lows and higher highs. You know, so the uptrend has sort of resurrected itself back to the upside. We had this multiple area of resistance here at sort of 107.90, which we bounced off of yesterday, surprise, surprise. And now we're kind of just sitting in a little bit in the middle of no man's land. But what I wanted you to take notice of is how sharply pointed up this 5 EMA is on the daily, and that'll act as dynamic support for this pair, all right? You know, if you look back here a little bit, if you look back here, this is the same sort of thing as what we're going to be looking for. You know, notice our price sort of separated itself from that 5 EMA, came back. You know, obviously had some other visual cues there to go off of, but came back. That 5 nicely sharply pointed up was then in a nice place to take on the long side of the trade, right? So if we use that same model, I'm not saying that the Aussie is necessarily that bullish as it was back then, but if we use that same model here, that 5 sharply pointed up. So what I'm looking for basically is price to come back, retest it, and continue. Now, keep in mind, this is the thing about moving averages where I think a lot of folks have some frustration, is that they really are a moving target. All right, they're a little bit of a figment of our imagination, so to speak. Dare I say smoke and mirrors a little bit on the old moving average front. So if price wanted to head up from here, this 5 EMA would look like it's been hit. Because if this candle went green, that, you know, if this candle all of a sudden just turned green there, right from where it is, it would positively look like it's hit that 5, and it would be dragged up to meet it. All right? So price has gone far enough that it could absolutely now head up and ride that, look like it's riding that 5, so to speak. All right, let me show you the 4-hour. Okay, and this is a swing fib of this rise on the 4-hour right here at 108.40. Okay, I happen to think, just because yesterday's daily Bollinger was closed, I happen to think that implied volatility is actually down here momentarily. So what I'm thinking is this, once again, Aussie dollar 4-hour got you looking at, is that we actually try and sort of lower high here and make our way back down to somewhere in the vicinity of 108 before trying again, all right, to the upside. I want to make this crystal clear. I am bullish on the Aussie dollar. I simply think that we're going to jog down one more notch and then continue up to 110. So my trade plan is, look, if the short presents itself, fine, but it's my least sort of priority trade. I'm looking for a long around sort of 107.80 to 108 that I'm trying to make 200 pips out of. I'm trying to take that up to 110, frankly, and then see what we got. Now, if it, you know, I'm going to wait for a 15-minute little change of trend through here and then pick up and then give it a low stop. You know, my trade plan's really going to change if we start breaking below 107.50, though. That, to me, is the cutoff. You cannot get below 107.50 and still be bullish here. So that's what I'm looking for, all right? Really, as a 107.80 to 107, you know, call it 108 long up to 110. Okay, now, keep in mind that this is a little fib of yesterday's rise. So could we go from here? You know, this is the 38 to 50%. Could we roll that from here? It's possible. But really what I'm hoping for is we sort of make a lower high, jog down, and then try and sort of head up. You know, if we break above sort of 108.60, I don't think we're going to be coming back. You know, I don't think then we're going to be able to make our way down to the bottom again. And if that's the case, we might have to look at something like that. But I'm not that crazy about it, right? Prefer to see our sort of double bottom here around 108, and we'll look at that trade. Okay, so there's the Aussie, nothing fancy there whatsoever. You look at the euro dollar, let me show you that. Here's the euro daily chart, same sort of logic prevails. You've got a little bit of a gap to that daily trend line pushing down. So what I'm looking for out of the euro very briefly is that we come and test that 5 and then head up to that trend line. All right, and that'll put us around sort of 144.50 possibly. Okay, nothing crazy there. So if I show you the 4 hour on the euro, 4 hour on the euro, I'd hope to see it at something like this. You know, say hello to say 43.20 and then long that up to 44.30, 44.50, and then that'll be our euro trade plan. Alright? Pretty simple stuff here all the way around, guys. You know, really not a whole lot. Rob, I know that Rob covered euro, so I don't want to, I hope I didn't contradict what he said there. But analysis is analysis, and that's why we all trade is we have difference of opinions on stuff. Alright, my name's David Pegler. Look at the European market, July the 25th, 2000. I'm sorry, July 26th, 2011. It's a quick sort of admin note. We're just launching a brand new website at FX Bootcamp. I'd encourage everybody to come by and check it out. The latest and greatest edition. Alright, guys, welcome. Always welcome your remarks and comments on YouTube and the blog. Take it easy, everybody. Talk to you tomorrow.